Hey guys, welcome to AVP Trivia Question Number 1. Now, during this game's campaign, while using the Marine, can you encounter a Praetorian before the boss battle? If you can, please tell me where. If you can't, please tell me no. Answer that question in the comment section. Alright, so, we'll move on to the multiplayer match here. So I am using Predator, and we are playing in Refinery here. Refinery is one of the two maps that I really like out of the standard maps. It's one of those maps that has a really good design. It's not really too simplistic. It's got a lot of hallways. It's got like three different levels or floors that you can go to depending what species you are. And which is what I like. I like maps that have a more intricate kind of design that, you know, are not just too standard, like just one hallway, one floor. You know, something that's not too simple like that. I like places where you can run around in different levels, different floors, go through a lot of tunnels, a lot of hallways. I like that kind of stuff. Alright, so right there, my teammate got taken down by one of the Marines. But, you know, the thing with this game is you are going to get stealth killed, whether you like it or not. It's going to happen. Because the way the auto-aim system works in the game is it's going to, like, aim assist you or auto-aim lock onto one of the targets. And the thing with this game that's different from standard or old school first person shooters is you can't really take on more than one target at the same time. It's kind of possible you could do it with the shoulder cannon, but it's not something you can rely on every single time, I'd say, because you are going to run out of energy for that weapon. But when I'm talking about just the basics, you know, just the basic weapons, just the melee combat, the counter system, the blocking system, that stuff, you can't really take on more than one enemy at one time. And even for people that are really good, when you're attacking one person, the other person is going to attack you from the side or from behind and get to you. So it's very hard in this type of game to go flawless. I've never done it. I'm still trying to do it. It would be much easier if you kind of just take some mines or take a shoulder cannon and just like camp out somewhere very high and kind of defend off who's coming towards you. But I'm not the type of player who kind of sits there and waits for a target. There's a lot of people who play ranked matches and, you know, they just kind of just take the shoulder cannon and just want easy XP and stay in one tower. But when you do that in ranked matches, it can cause a lot of people to get frustrated or mad and they'll just leave and then you're not going to get any XP, you see. So with this game, what I find is it's really hard to go flawless because there's a lot of factors you got to take into account. The way the auto aim system works, you know, the stealth kills that are one hit kill pretty much, and the three different species that kind of have their own way of tracking each other. You know, the Predator does have the vision mode, which can, like, it'll pick up anybody pretty much across the map, as long as they are within view. You know, if they're behind something, he can't really see them. But the Marines, they have the motion tracker, so even if you are a Predator hunting Marine, the Marine can kind of track your position if you're trying to find them, especially if the Marine is taking cover or taking shelter in a little room or behind a corner or behind a box or something. You know, he can pick up your signature by you moving, of course. So, and the aliens, you know, they have that wall hack, as we call them. They have like the X-ray vision through the walls, but it does only see a certain amount of range. You know, it can't really see across the map. But in a way, I kind of think they're all balanced, you know, the way they kind of track each other, you know, because the way you look at it, you know, not one species has a big advantage over the other, the way that you kind of track the other person. Okay, take for example, like, yeah, the Predator can see heat vision, so he'll see the Marine across the map. But if the Marine goes behind a wall around a corner, he can see the Predator's movements if he's coming toward him or not. So he can kind of react accordingly. Okay, the Predator is not moving. Should I take the chance of going out into the open, or should I run away and try to go a different route, you know? So it's things like those you gotta take into consideration if, you know, you think, is the game really more leaning towards one species or not? Although I will say, I really wish the console players did have that last PC patch that would have fixed, you know, the final things that were kind of like a little bit unbalanced. And that's not relating to the terms of like the vision modes and stuff like that. That's other things. Refinery, I find, is one of the good maps. I can see why they chose it for the demo, because it is a pretty good map. I don't think I would have liked playing on the other maps for a demo, because the thing is, Gateway and Ruins are very large maps, but Jungle is very small. Actually, I want to talk about jungle. Here's the weird thing about jungle map. In player match, you are not allowed to... Well, this refers to console players, okay? For Xbox and PS3. If you try to host a player match on jungle, it for player match, it's only supported for up to 8 players. So if you want to host a game for 9 or 10 players, you won't be allowed to select that map. So the weird thing is, I've gone into a few ranked matches where we actually ended up in jungle with 12 and 16 players, and it was a complete mess. Like really, it was really fucked up. There are not enough spawn locations or spawn timers even to kind of support that many players on a small map. So why would it allow it for ranked matches when you need XP? Something that's that goofy and that retarded, you know, settings like that that isn't balanced. Something like that should have been available for player match, not for ranked. Because when you look at ranked, they have, They have team balancing is always on. So you don't have a large amount of predators, you know, on one group of aliens that has like one alien, or a group of marines that has like one or two marines. So, I mean, in most cases, it's not going to be like that. So, you know, it makes me wonder, why did they do that for ranked for jungle? Like, it doesn't make any sense, you know? But whatever. I wish I would have recorded that match, but at the time I didn't have my setup kind of, you know, properly installed. So I'm like, well, you know, it was weird. Of course, the match didn't last too long because we reached the goal really fast anyways. But, you know, that is one thing I didn't really get with this game. Like, I want to play like 9 or 10 players in player matches for jungle, but it just doesn't support it for player match. But in ranked, it does. Why? Why would you allow in ranked? When, you know, ranked is more about skill, you know, people are working their hardest to earn their kills, even though some people kind of resort to cheap shit, you know. But, you know, it just didn't make any sense, really. So, moving along here. So, Refinery is one of the two maps I do like, this and Ruins. I think the map packs in this game have the best maps in the entire game, I'd say. Unfortunately, people still don't play them or have them, you know. It seems a lot of people just kind of play the game, you know, just because they saw the game on a low price and they wanted to pick it up. But a lot of people just don't even know that there is, like, two map packs. And a lot of people ask me, too, you know, should I get the map packs? And I tell them, well, honestly, no, do not buy them. It'll be a waste of your money. Like, the only way you can actually play them is just, like, having a group of friends that have it. And if you kind of hope to get them into some player rank matches, it's not going to happen. You know, the weird thing is, I actually ran into more DLC matches in ranked than in player. Like, in player matches, you'll never see them hosted, except for, like, in Survivor. But for the deathmatch game modes, you know, you'll never see them. So, I've only seen people play Tempest and Hive a little bit on Survivor in player matches. But out of all the deathmatch modes that I've played for ranked, I have run into a few that actually have the DLC maps. But it was usually, like, maybe 4 or 5 players in match, and that was it. And some of them don't really stay the full match, you know. I don't blame them because some of the maps, like, the crash site and the place with the fire, those are really big maps, so they really need a good amount of players to kind of support that large map. But, yeah, for custom maps, even though I think they are the best, it's just really too bad that not many people have the map packs, really. But what can you do, eh? But you know, I bought them at the time they were released because I'm a really big fan of this game. I just wanted to have them, like, regardless if people would actually buy them or not. But you know, that's just the way it is sometimes. Some games get popular and some games don't. So I actually want to talk about that. I actually went back to Modern Warfare 3, as you guys saw, like, 2 weeks ago, I think it was. Was it 2 weeks ago? It was a very short time, and I just got tired of it, like, really fast. So I'm gonna get rid of the game again, because I just don't feel it, you know? You know, it was fun, like, the first few months, and then I kind of just drained out on it. It's not one of those games I can find myself playing forever and ever. Like, take for example this game. I've been playing it for 2 years since it came out. Recorded so many matches that I participate in, and I'm still going. I love this game because it's different, but, you know, some people just kind of like different games. That's just the way it is, man. So, Anyways, guys, that's it for now. I just wanted to ramble on. I'll see you guys later.